Okay, here we go on this one. A is 6, B is 5, C is negative 1. And look, 6 minus 1 is 5. This thing, we're going to get a perfect square under the radical. The reason I know that is because it factors. Actually, and that's a good thing for you to think about, you could actually use the quadratic formula to factor, because if there's not, like on this one right here, there wasn't a perfect square right here, this one is not going to factor. But when there is a perfect square under there, A is 6, it does factor. And here I get negative 1. So I get negative 5 plus or minus. That one's 25. That one is 24. That's 12. Negative 5 plus or minus root 49 over 12. Negative 5 plus or minus 7 over 12. So negative 5 plus 7 over 12, that's 2 over 12, that's 1/6. And then negative 5 minus 7 over 12, that's negative 12 over 12, that's negative 1. But I already knew that anyway, because look, 6 minus 1 is 5. That tells me this thing factored, and down here I was suspecting I would get a perfect square under here. Only perfect squares under there if it factors.